ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக. திஸ் இஸ் முத்து மீனாட்சி ஃப்ரம் பொன் வித்யாஸ்ரம். ஐ வெல்கம் எவ்ரி ஒன் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் செஷன் ஆன் கிளாஸ் 8 மேத்தமேட்டிக்ஸ். திஸ் இஸ் சாப்டர் 8, கம்பேரிங் குவான்டிட்டீஸ். ஹியர் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சால்வ் சம் ஆஃப் த ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் எக்ஸசைஸ் 8.3, அண்ட் திஸ் வில் பி பார்ட் 6. சில்ட்ரன், ஸ்டூடெண்ட் லைஃப் இஸ் த சீட் ஆஃப் யுவர் லைஃப். And moreover, it is the best part of our life. So please plant it wisely, that is in a wise manner. I repeat children, student life is the seed of your life. So plant it wisely. Let's start our today's session. So in the previous session, we have completed till problem number 1, that is subdivision E of exercise 8.3. Now I'm going to continue with second problem of the same exercise, that is exercise 8.3. Question number 2. Kamala borrowed rupees 26,400 from a bank to buy a scooter at the rate of 15% per annum compounded yearly. What amount will she pay at the end of 2 years and 4 months to clear the loan? And moreover, they have also given you the hint. So given the principal value is rupees 26,400. The rate of interest is 15% per annum compounded yearly. Number of years is 2 years and 4 months. So first let us calculate the amount for 2 years by using the formula. Amount for 2 years is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N. That is equal to 26,400. Into 1 plus 15 by 100 whole power 2. That is equal to 26,400 into 23 by 20 whole power 2. That is equal to 26,400 into 23 by 20 into 23 by 20. On simplifying this, you will get the result as rupees 34,914. So we have calculated for 2 years. Now we are having the remaining part, that is for 4 months. So 4 months is nothing but, that is 4 by 12. So the principal for 4 months, you will take this value as the principal. So principal value is equal to rupees 34,914. Now we will calculate the simple interest with this principal. The formula for simple interest is SI is equal to PNR by 100, that is equal to 34,914 into 15 into 14 divided by 100 into 12. On simplifying the result, the value will be rupees 1745.70, that is 1745.70. So amount after 2 years and 4 months, that is equal to 34,914 plus 1745.7, that is equal to rupees 36,659.7. Hence, the amount paid by Kamala is equal to rupees 36,659.7. So children, please remember, here the number of years is 2 years and 4 months. So first we have calculated the amount for 2 years, then we are, with that amount as the principal, we are calculating simple interest. Finally, we are calculating the amount that has to be paid by Kamala. This completes problem number 2. Let's move on to third problem. Fabina borrows rupees 12,500 at 12% per annum for 3 years at simple interest, and Radha borrows the same amount for the same time period at 10% per annum compounded annually. Who pays more interest and by how much? We'll discuss the solution. For Fabina, the principal value is rupees 12,500. The rate of interest is 12% and number of years is 3 years. First, Fabina has borrowed the amount for 3 years at simple interest. So for the girl Fabina, you have to calculate simple interest. But for Radha, it is compound interest because they have given compounded annually. So please distinguish these two features. That is, for Fibina it is SI and for Radha it is CI. So now we will calculate SI for Fibina. SI is equal to PNR by 100. On substituting the given data, which will give you the result as 12,500 into 12 into 3 by 100. That is equal to rupees 4,500. So now the simple interest for Fibina is rupees 4,500. Let us calculate the compound interest for Radha. The same principle, that principal value is rupees 12,500, rate of interest is 10% per annum and number of years is 3 years. Compound interest can be calculated by the formula CI is equal to A minus B, but for amount you have a separate formula. Amount can be calculated by the relation P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N minus P. So let us substitute the data. That is 12,500 into 1 plus 10 by 100 whole power 3 minus 12,500. On simplifying this, you will get the result as 12,500 into 11 by 10 whole power 3 minus 12,500. That is equal to 12,500 into 1331 by 1000 minus 12,500. So we can take 12,500 as a common term. If you take it outside, inside the bracket, you will get it as 12,500 multiplied by 1331 by 1000 minus 1. So on solving this, the final result will be rupees 4137.50. So now we have calculated compound interest for Radha, simple interest for Fibina. We have to see who pays the more interest and by how much. So let us find out the difference between both. That is nothing but 4137.5 compound interest and 4500 is your simple interest. On subtracting both, the difference will be rupees 362.5. To conclude, Fibina pays more interest. That is, her simple interest is rupees 4500. Fibina pays more interest by rupees 362.5. So to conclude, for Fibina with the given data, we are finding simple interest. For Radha with the given data, we are calculating compound interest. And we are finding out which is more, and we are also finding the difference, because they have asked you in the question, who pays more interest and by how much. So this completes this problem. We have also calculated who has paid more and by what is the difference. We will move on to problem number 4 of the same exercise. I borrowed rupees 12,000 from Jamshed at 6% per annum simple interest for 2 years. Had I borrowed this sum at 6% per annum compound interest, what extra amount would I have to pay? Children, this is also this problem that is similar to the previous problem. That is, for the same principal and the same rate of interest, you have to calculate simple interest separately and compound interest separately, and then finally you have to see the difference. Let us discuss the solution for this. Now here the principal is given as rupees 12,000, rate of interest is 6% per annum and number of years is 2 years. The formula for simple interest is SI is equal to PNR by 100, that is equal to 12,000 into 6 into 2 by 100, that is equal to rupees 1,440. With the same data, we have to calculate compound interest also. So CI is equal to A minus P. We already know the formula, CI is equal to A minus P. So I am going to substitute the formula for A. That is, A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N minus P. That is nothing but 12,000 into 1 plus 6 by 100 whole power 2 minus 12,000. So if you simplify this 1 plus 6 by 100, you will get the result as 53 by 50. So you can write it as 12,000 into 53 by 50 whole power 2 minus 12,000. So take 12,000 as a common factor. So 12,000 into 53 by 50 whole power 2 minus 1. On solving this in the next step, the result will be 12,000 into 2809 by 2500 minus 1. If you simplify, the final result will be 7416 by 5, that is nothing but rupees 1483.20. So the compound interest for the same principal, that is 12,000, and rate of interest 6% and number of years 2 years, the value is rupees 1483.20, whereas the simple interest is rupees 1440. Now look at the last line. What extra amount would I have to pay? So again, we need to find the difference between SI and CI. Here CI is greater, so CI minus SI, that is 1483.20 minus 1440 is equal to rupees 43.20. So the extra amount the person has to pay is equal to rupees 43.20. So be clear with the formula, children. SI is equal to PNR by 100. For compound interest, you can calculate the amount by the formula if it is annually. That is, if it is per annum, A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N. This completes problem number 4. We'll move on to 5th problem of exercise 8.3. Vasudevan invested rupees 60,000 at an interest rate of 12% per annum compounded half yearly. What amount would he get after subdivision 1 after 6 months, subdivision 2 after 1 year? Let us discuss the solution, children. Here the principal is rupees 60,000. Time is 6 months, okay? 6 months. If it is 6 months, means you can write it as 6 by 12. So that is nothing but 1 by 2. Here it is compounded half yearly. Look at the question. It is compounded half yearly. They have mentioned in the question is half yearly. In case if it is half yearly, you have to find out 2n. So 2n is nothing but 2 into 1 by 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Finally, the value for n will be 1. That's what I have given here. That is, n is equal to 1 year. So rate of interest is 12% per annum. Look at the question again. It is 12% per annum. 12% per annum. So what is the meaning is 12% per annum compounded half yearly. So what you should do, you have to divide it by 2. So the rate of interest will be 12 by 2, that is equal to 6%. Now let us substitute in the formula. A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N, that is equal to 60,000 into 1 plus 6 by 100 whole power 1, that is equal to 60,000 into 1 plus 3 by 50 whole power 1. On solving this, you will get the result as 60,000 into 53 by 50, that is equal to rupees 63,600. So after 6 months, Vasudevan would have got rupees 63,600. The answer we have completed only for the first subdivision. Let's move on to second subdivision. Again the same thing, but it is after 1 year. Children, if it is after 1 year, it is half yearly. As it is half yearly, the n will be 2n. So here it is 1 year. So n multiplied by 2, that is equal to 2. So the value for n is 2. Now the principal is same. It is not changed. It is equal to 60,000. Rate of interest is 12 by 2, that is 6%. We'll substitute in the formula. A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N. That is 60,000 into 1 plus 6 by 100 whole power 2. If you solve this in the next step, you can get the result as 60,000 into 53 by 50 whole power 2. On simplifying, this will be 24 into 2809. That is nothing but rupees 67,416. So the required amount will be rupees 67,416. So in this session, we have completed from problem number 2 till 5. We'll continue the remaining problems in the next session. Children, to conclude, there is a difference between not knowing and not knowing it. By the point of time, if you are not knowing things, that's okay. But at least later, that is from now on, from this minute, please start learning new things. We have completed till 8.3, 5th problem. Please practice till that sum. Thank you. Thank you very much, children.